Good morning, students. Today we start 1B Mathematics 1B. In this, the first chapter is locus. Okay, so we'll start with locus. So, what is locus? The set of points moving in a plane satisfying a given condition is called locus. See, I wrote the definition. The set of points moving in a plane satisfying a given condition is locus. That means, see, I'll give an example to explain this definition. See, the example is, now suppose I am shooting some points. Okay, let P, Q, R are some points in a plane. See, I am assuming some points P, Q, R on a plane. Now, what is a locus? Locus means it has to satisfy a certain condition. So here, what is a certain condition? I am assuming some points on a plane. Now, I'll assume one more fixed point. See, what is the meaning of fixed point? Fixed point means this point is fixed at that place. It won't go, it will not move. Locus of a point means the point keeps on moving. Now suppose this point is at P. The point is at P. Now the distance from P to some called C, the distance from P to C, I am assuming as K. The distance from P to C is K. Now this point P has moved to some other point called Q. Okay. Now this distance, if we measure, it is same. What is the distance? Same K units. Again, when the same point comes to R, you measure the distance. The distance is same, K units. Okay, now the point P to C is, say, K units. Again, from Q to C, the distance is K units. Again, from distance R to C is also K units. Now, here, these locus of a points are at equal distance from a fixed point. And when we join all these points, we get a curve. This curve is nothing but circle. Now here, we got circle. How we got the circle? The set of points moving in a plane satisfying a given condition. What is that given condition? Cp is equal to Qc. See, Cp is equal to Cq. And you can also say Qc is equal to Cr. It satisfies a certain condition. What is that condition? Cp is equal to Cq and Cq is equal to Cr. Okay. So, since it satisfies a certain condition, we say these are the locus of a point. PQR are called locus of a point. So, here locus means it has to satisfy a certain condition. Just remember that locus of a point means what? It has to satisfy a certain condition. Now, we do problems on this locus. Now, first problem, okay, see, find the equation of locus of a point which is at a distance of 5 from A, 4 gamma minus 3, okay. Now, we have to find out the equation of locus of a point using this condition. Now, here, in this problem, they are saying locus of a point. So, here, locus of a point, we need to assume. So, I will assume, let P is equal to x comma y be any point. P is equal to x comma y be any point. That means, see, locus of a point we are assuming as x comma y. For all the problems we need to assume x comma y as a locus of a point. Now what is given? Let's see. Find the equation of locus of a point. What is the locus of a point here? X comma y. And what is the x point here? 4 comma minus 3. That means the distance from P to A is given as 5 units. Here the condition is the distance from P to A is given as 5 units. So here I will write PA is equal to 5. I will write PA is equal to 5. Now what is PA? It is distance between two points. Now what is distance between two points? X1, Y1 and X2, Y2. It is X2 minus X1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the distance between two points. So here the same identity I'll apply here for this. So under root of what is PA? See, I am assuming x comma y as x2 y2 and x1 y1 as 4 comma minus 3. Substitute this. So PA is nothing but x minus 4 whole square plus y plus 3 whole square is equal to 5. I am finding the distance between 2 points. X2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1, but already it is a negative sign, minus into minus plus 3 whole square is equal to 5. As we need an equation here to eliminate the root, we square them on both sides. Now squaring them on both sides, so what we get, it is x minus 4 whole square plus y plus 3 whole square is equal to 5 square. Now I'll expand this. It is a minus b whole square, a square minus 2ab multiplied to 2, 2 fours are 8x plus b square, 4 square is 16, plus continue this one, a square 2ab, 2 threes are 6y, 2ab plus b square is 9. Then 5 square 25, we transpose, we get minus 25 is equal to 0. Now what is the equation of locus? First write x square, then I will write y square, x square plus y square minus 8x, then write y term, it is plus 6y, then constants, 16 plus 9, 25, 25 minus 25, 0. That means constants got eliminated, no need to write any constant, just write is equal to 0. So this is the equation of locus. So first problem is completed. Now second problem, find the equation of locus of a point which is equidistant from the points a minus b comma 2 and b 0 comma 4. Okay, so here first we assume let p is equal to x comma y be any point, be the locus of a point, or we can say p x comma y be the locus of a point. Here in the problem always find the equation of locus of a point, that point we need to assume. After assuming we find the equation. So for all the problems we will assume x comma y as locus of a point. So let p is equal to x comma y be any point. Now after that what they give is, this p x comma y is equidistant from a and b. See, equidistant from a and b. What is a given? Minus 3 comma 2. And what is b? It is 0 comma 4. See here, locus means we need a condition. In the last problem, the condition was pa is equal to 5. So here, the condition is, the locus of a point is equidistant from a and b. That means, the distance from p to a is equal to the distance from p to b. The distance from P to A is equal to the distance from P to B. So this is the condition in the problem. Now I find out PA, distance between P and A. I am finding, that is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. I am finding the distance between P and A. This is to be equated to the distance from P to B. What is distance from P to B? It is x minus 0 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square. Again, it is a distance from P to B. P to A and P to B distance. Now, we have roots on both the sides. Roots get cancelled, or you square them on both sides, the root get cancelled. After eliminating the roots, see, let us square them on both sides here. When we square them on both sides, roots get eliminated on both sides. Now, after that, what we get without roots, I like x plus 3 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to x minus 0 is x. Just write x square plus y minus 4 whole square. This thing we have. Now what we have to do, just expand this to get the equation of locus. So I am expanding, a plus b whole square, x square plus 2ab, 2 3 are 6x plus b square 9. This is a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square. A square minus 2ab. 2 is a 4y plus 2 square 4 is equal to x square as it is plus I am expanding y minus 4 whole square, that is y square minus 8y. Y square goes on 8y plus 2 square is 16. Now the expansion part is completed. Now here x square is equal to x square. X square is positive. Here x square is positive, but they are on both sides. This is LHS, that is RHS. In this case, if they are same signs, you can cancel x square and x square. You can cancel when they are of same signs and they both should be on two sides. One is LHS, one is RHS. Now, y square is equal to y square, you can cancel. After that, what we have is any cancellation? No. Now we don't have any cancellation. So what we do? First find x term. I write 6x. Then y terms. This is minus 4y. Any other y term means we have on the other side. Transpose this minus 8y to the left side. So it will become plus 8y. Okay. Then 9 plus 4 is 13. Okay, now this plus 16 you transpose to the other side, it will become minus 16 is equal to 0. Now, what is the equation we are getting? 6x plus 4y minus 3 is equal to 0. 6x minus 4y. Minus 4y plus 8y, sorry. Minus 4y plus 8y is 4y. And 13 minus 16 is minus 3 is equal to 0. So, this is the equation of locus. Okay, so this is completed. So next problem, find the equation of locus of a point P such that distance of P from the origin is twice the distance of P from A 1 comma 2. So first we write the condition. See, for all the problems we assume let P is equal to x comma y be any point. After assuming P x comma y, now we write the condition by repeating the question. Find the equation of locus of a point such that the distance of P from origin. See, how we represent distance of P from origin? The distance of P from origin. Origin means what? O. Coordinates are 0, comma 0. What is A given to us? 1, comma 2. So the distance of P from the origin, OP. The distance of P from the origin is denoted by OP is, here is means is equal to, is means is equal to, twice, what is the meaning of twice, two times the distance of P from A, distance of P from A, so this is the condition. I'll repeat this, find the equation of locus of a point such that the distance of P from the origin is nothing but OP. Is means is equal to, twice means two times, distance of P from A, distance of P from A is PA or you can write AP. So now OP, you find the distance between two points O and P. So what we get is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Here always I assume x2, y2 as x, comma y. I am assuming x2, y2 as x, comma y and I am finding the distance between O and P. X2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square is equal to 2 times the distance of P from A. Distance of P from A. So here I am finding the distance from P and A. It is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So this is the distance. Okay, now to eliminate the roots, we need to do square them on both sides. So when I square them on both sides, what I get is x minus 0 is x square as it is plus y square as it is under root whole square is equal to 2 square will become 4 into x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square under root and whole square. Square then one whole square. So in the next step, roots get eliminated. So x square plus y square is equal to 4 into 4 into what we have without roots already. It is x minus 1 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square. Okay. Now x square plus y square as it is equal to 4 into, and expand x minus 1 whole square, x square minus 2ab plus b square. A square, and you get 2, 1s are 2x, 2ab plus b square is 1. So similarly here, y square minus 4y plus 4, y square minus 2ab, 2s are 4y plus 4. Now after that, what I do, I simplify this. I'll simplify this. That means, see, x square plus y square is equal to, okay, I'll multiply all these terms with 4. Okay, all these terms with 4. So what we get? 4x square minus 8x minus 8x. 4 ones are 4 plus 4. Then 4 into 4, it is 16y, then 4 4s are, it is 16, plus 16, I multiplied everything with 4. Now I simplify this, see, we have x square, transpose this 4x square to the left side, it will become minus 4x square, then plus y square, okay, transpose, do you have any y square term here? No, we don't have any y square term, so x square minus 4x square plus y square. X term, we transpose on the other side, minus 8x. Okay, then y term, transpose on this other side, sorry, this will become plus 8x and this will become plus 16y. Right side terms, transpose to left side, so it changes the sign, plus 16y. Then what is 4 plus 16? 20. That also we transpose on the other side, minus 20 is equal to 0. Okay, x square and minus 4x. If we are transposing to the left side, it changes the sign. Y square is only one term we have, so write as it is. Transpose 8x on the other side, plus 8x, and 16y will become plus 16y. 4 plus 16, 20, we are transposing on the other side, will become minus 20 is equal to 0. So, what we get is, minus 3x square plus y square plus 8x plus 16y minus 20 is equal to 0 is the equation of locus. So this problem is completed. Okay. Next problem, find the equation of locus of a point equidistant from A to comma 0 and y axis. Here we mentioned y axis and equidistant. Okay. So here first we assume let P is equal to x comma y be any point of locus. Okay. Always we have to assume this. What is A given? 2 comma 0. Okay. Now here the point x comma y is equidistant from A 2 comma 0 and y axis. What is the point on y axis? The point on y axis will be 0 comma y. Point on y axis is on y axis always x coordinate is 0. So what we assume whenever we say the point on y axis, we take the point as 0 comma y. If it is x axis, suppose if it is x axis, you have to take the point as x comma 0. In case of x axis, y coordinate is 0. So if it is x axis, we assume the point as x comma 0. Since it is y axis, what is the point on y axis? 0 comma y. Okay, point on y axis will be 0 comma y. Now, after assuming all these three points, what is the condition we have to get here? Find the equation of locus of a point equidistant from locus of a point is equidistant from A. Equidistant means they are at equal distances. That means PA is equal to PB. Equidistant from A and locus of a point is equidistant to B. So it is PA is equal to PB. Now what is PA? Distance between two points. Okay. So under root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square is equal to PB. It is x minus 0 whole square plus y minus y whole square. X minus 0 whole square plus y minus y whole square. This is the root function. Now, square them on both sides. Both the roots get eliminated. So, roots got eliminated. So, I'll write what is left. It is x minus 2 whole square plus y square. No need to write the root. What is y minus 0? Y. So, y square as is. Is equal to x minus 0 is x square as is. And y minus y is 0. 0 square is 0. 0 plus x square is x square. So, no need to write this y minus y 0. That 0 no need to write. So, these are the things we have. Okay. So, now I expand the first one. What we get? X square minus 2a equals 4x plus 4 plus y square is equal to x square. Expand. This is a square minus 2ab plus b square y square x square as is. Okay. After expanding, it's very clear that we can cancel x square and x square on both sides. After cancellation, the remaining part is the equation of locus. So, I'll write this equation as locus as y square. I'm writing in order. First positive term, next remaining terms is equal to 0. This is the equation of locus. So, this problem is completed. So, the next problem, find the equation of locus of a point P, the square of whose distance from the origin is 4 times y coordinate. This is a question. The square of whose distance from origin is 4 times the y coordinate. So, first here we will assume the locus of a point as x, y. And here what are the terms they mentioned? Origin. Origin means what we need to write. Origin is 4 is equal to 0, 0. Y coordinate means y. What is y coordinate? It's just y. So, I am not represent here. Y coordinate, just remember what is y coordinate? Y. So, now I write the condition. Find the equation of locus of a point P. The square of whose distance from origin. The distance from origin to the locus of a point we write it as OP. The distance from origin to the locus of a point is OP. But, just refer the question. The square of whose distance from origin. The square of whose distance, just put the square. The square of whose distance from origin to P is OP square is equal to 4 times, it's multiply, 4 times y coordinate. Just write y. 4 times y coordinate, 4y. Okay. Now, we find out the distance between 2 points OP. This is nothing but x minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square. I am not writing square root. The reason is the square and root get cancels. So it is x minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square is equal to 4y. Is equal to 4y. Now what is x minus 0? It is x square plus y square is equal to 4y. Is the equation of locus. Okay. So this problem is completed. Okay, next problem, find the equation of locus of a point P such that PA square plus PB square is equal to 2C square, where A is equal to A comma 0 and B is equal to minus A comma 0. So, I am assuming the point as x comma y and what is AAK is given as A comma 0 and B is minus A comma 0. So, locus means we need a condition. So that condition is given to us in the problem as PA square plus PB square is equal to 2C square. So I will write PA square plus PB square is equal to 2C square. Okay. Now PA square is what? PA means what? Distance between 2 points. PB is also distance between 2 points. We find out the distance between 2 points. And I am not writing the root in both the cases because we have a square. Always whole square and root get cancelled. So now I find out distance. X minus A whole square plus Y minus 0 whole square. I am finding the distance between P and A. X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square plus PB square. X2 minus C. X2 minus X1. Already we have a minus. Minus into minus plus. So it is x plus a whole square. X2 minus of minus. Actually x2 minus of minus. plus a whole square plus y minus 0 whole square is equal to 2c square as it is. Now x minus a whole square I will expand. So what we get? X square minus 2ab, 2ax plus a square and plus y square. Read out. Plus x square plus 2ax plus a square plus y square. I'm expanding. X square plus 2ax plus a square and plus y square. And this is 2c square as it is. Okay. So now x square plus x square. 2x square. Okay. Minus 2ax plus 2x cancels. Then after that, y square plus y square, it is 2y square. Then a square plus a square is 2a square. And this 2c square will transpose on the other side. It will become minus 2c square is equal to 0. Okay. Now, throughout this equation, we can take 2 common. If we take 2 common, what we get? X square plus y square plus a square minus c square is equal to 0. In the next step, this 2 goes to the denominator on the other side. This 2 goes to the on the other side of the denominator. This will become this 2 goes to this side. 0 by 2. What is 0 by 2? 0. So next step, without this 2, we write. So that is x square plus y square plus a square minus c square is equal to 0 is the equation of locus. So this problem is completed. See, next problem. Find the equation of locus of a point B if the line segment joining the points 2, 3 and minus 1, 5 subtends a right angle at B. Right angle means 90 degrees. Right angle at B. So here what we do is we draw a triangle. Okay. Right angle at B. We draw a triangle. This is right angle at B. At B, it subtends an angle 90 degrees. And this is A and this is B. Okay. Right angle at B. Now, we will solve this. So, let P is equal to x, y be any point. And what is A is equal to 2, 3. And b is equal to minus 1, 5. A is equal to 2, 3. B is equal to minus 1, 5. Now subtend a right angle at P. See, right angle at P. By seeing this right angle triangle, we have a condition. Because for locus we need a condition. So here subtend a right angle at P. Using that, we have get one condition. Whenever we see a right angle, we get an idea of Pythagoras theorem. So what is Pythagoras theorem? The longest side square is equal to sum of the squares on other two sides. Longest side square is equal to sum of the squares on other two sides. That means here the longest side is AB, hypotenuse. So I will write AB square is equal to, now the remaining two, AB square plus PB square. AB square plus PB square. So AB square plus PB square. Okay. So now we find the distance between two points. These two we find the distance, okay? So distance between two points. I'll not write the root as we have a square, okay? So now the distance between two points. X2 minus x1 whole square. X2, actually I should write minus. So already we have a minus. Minus into minus plus. X2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. It is 3 minus 5 whole square is equal to distance from A to B. A to B. That is x minus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square. X minus 2 whole square plus y minus 3 whole square. Plus now PB square. It is x plus 1 whole square plus PB. X2 minus x1. Minus 2 minus plus. X plus 1 whole square plus y minus 5 whole square. You got this. Now we expand this. Okay. What is 2 plus 1? 3. 3 square 9.
Nice.
What is 3 minus 5? Minus 2. Minus 2 squared is 4. It is plus 4 is equal to, in fact, is a squared minus 2ab, 2's are 4x, plus b squared, 2 squared is 4, plus a minus b whole squared, a squared minus 2ab, 2 3's are 6, y, plus 3 squared, 9. Okay, plus, this is a plus b whole squared, a squared plus 2ab, 2 1's are 2x, plus 1, plus y squared minus 2ab, 2 5's are 10, y, and y squared is 25, we expanded, after expanding, this is simplified. Okay, before simplifying, one thing what we observe is, 9 is equal to 9, you can cancel, and 4 is equal to 4, we can cancel. Okay, now, x squared plus x squared will become 2x squared, and y squared plus y squared will become 2y squared. Then x terms, minus 4x plus 2x, minus 4x plus 2x is minus 2x. Then y terms, minus 6y minus 10y is minus 16y. Then constants, numbers, constants, 1 plus 25 is 26, is equal to 0. Okay, now we got the equation of locus. After getting the equation of locus, we have a common in this equation. See, 2, 2, 2, 16, 26, these all are divisible by 2. So I will take 2 common. So if I take 2 common, I get x squared plus y squared minus x. Because 2 1's are 2, no need to write the coefficient as 1, it is understood. So x squared plus y squared minus x, 2 8's are 16, and 2 13's are 26, is equal to 0. And no need to write the common 2. Whatever the common we have taken, no need to write. What is the reason? Because on RHS, what we have? 0. Whenever we have 0 in RHS, no need to write this common term. Okay. So this is the equation of locus. So this is completed. Okay, see, this is a today's class. So please practice these problems. And next class we have. So please practice all these problems. And next class we will continue this chapter locus. Thank you.